You know, many of us, and again, wallahi, I'm not attacking. But we need to understand, my brothers and sisters, our deen is what? Our deen, again, it's not up to you and I. Our deen is how the Prophet of Allah and his companions, they are the model. How they understood deen is what you and I have to take. Today now, when it comes, I'll give you a classic example. When it comes to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course, a mercy to mankind. The man who had sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest akhlaq and manners and adab, manners and ways and etiquettes and love and compassion. He is the absolute pinnacle. There is no greater than him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But you find that even amongst Muslims, amongst ourselves, we tend to paint this image of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not complete. That the Prophet of Allah was always smiling. He was always happy. He never got angry. He never cursed anyone. Yes, well, I agree. His overall character was love and compassion and smiling. But we make him out to be almost as if like, you know, I don't want to say anything disrespectful towards him, but we paint this image that's not true. That he never got angry, that he never raised his voice. Sometimes I give a khutbah and I get a bit worked up and maybe I start screaming or whatever the case is. I have 100 people who are ready to pull me up. Brother, why are you speaking like this? This is not Islam. The Prophet of Allah was never like this. He was always calm and beautiful and polite and smiling. He always spoke politely. Well, I agree that that was his overall character. But what's your proof for this? Why do you make the Prophet out to be something he entirely wasn't? The companions in Sahih narrations, they describe him sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they used to say that we used to be in the masjid and he used to be giving the khutbah, the sermon. He used to raise his voice so loud, he could be heard in the marketplaces. What was he doing? Singing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star? But let's be honest, what was he doing? Why was his voice heard in the marketplace? They used to say his face would go red, veins would appear on his neck, his eyes used to go red. He would address us as if there was an army coming. Why do you deny this part of your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? It's important. To follow him, you need to have the complete picture. Don't just pick and choose what makes you happy. And the opposite is true. Some people try to paint the Prophet like as if he had a sword in his hand day and night. No, he didn't. Give justice to his image. Yes, he was overly pleasant, overly smart, you know. Yes, this was his overall character. But he did get angry. He did get upset. He did curse. He did warn. He did raise his voice. Why do we deny that for? When it comes to Allah, we do the exact same thing. Even amongst Muslims. That Allah, you know, that Islam is peaceful and loving and caring, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafoor Rahim, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most loving, the most caring, He's the one that forgives all sins. And it's true, I don't deny that. By no means am I taking the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala away from Him, no. But we stress on His mercy so much so that we forget that He's severe in punishment. And this is what I want to highlight here tonight. Don't make the deen out to be something. It's not. Paint the full picture. Because what's happening now is most of us, myself included, we have this image of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, there's certain verses of Quran and authentic hadith we love spreading. And I know you mean well, but what you don't realize is if you don't balance it, you can do more harm than good. I'll give you an example. Quran. So no one can argue. No one can argue, it's Quran, authentic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran what? ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. And my mercy encompasses all things. And we love the verse. We thrive on it. But have you noticed that's all we say? What did he say before? What did he say after? Is irrelevant. ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. Brother, stop being harsh. Stop being extreme. What are you doing? No. Brother, and then the other hadith. من قال لا إله إلا الله و دخل الجنة ما شاء الله. So everyone pack your bags and let's all go home and sing Kumbaya together. صحيح حديث. Can you argue? Come on, دليل. Can you? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Wow. And this is my topic tonight. That my brothers, unfortunately, and forgive me, you know, I don't know what you want to call me. Raw, a realist, I don't know. But for me, I feel that this is how I benefit and this is how I move forward. So therefore, I'm sharing it with you like I like it to be shared with me. Whatever you like, take, and whatever you don't like, please drop it and leave it. But when we talk about our deen, it's always hopeful and Allah's mercy encompasses all things. And don't worry about it. Man qala la ilaha illallah is going to enter Jannah. And that, you know what, at the end of the day, nothing's going to happen. Well, that's far from the truth. Because this same Allah that says in the Quran, wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay, He also says in the Quran, feed me. Allah says, and I warn you against myself. No one wants to talk about that. No one has an interpretation for that. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسُكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Oh, you who believe, save yourselves and your families from the hellfire. Forgive me, my brothers, but this is what I feel. Most of us feel and think that, you know what, that this is a big joke. That your life and your existence in this world is some big joke. And that on the day of judgment, Allah is just going to say to everyone, did you all get scared? Well, don't worry about it. It was all fun and games. All of you now go run and play. Hasha lillah. My brothers, your life is real. Allah is not playing games. Your existence in this world is not by chance. But for you and I, now, you know what, that I'm alive because 30 odd years ago, mum and dad got together and there you go, I'm here now. No, you exist because Allah created you and He created you for a reason. And Allah's watching you. And everything you do is recorded with Allah. Some people think, yeah, you know what, there's 1.7 billion Muslims. So really what I do doesn't benefit and doesn't harm. No, you're wrong. It does. Allah is watching your every move. When you call Allah, Allah is there. Allah watches and listens to every one of you. Simultaneously, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't get lost. Don't think that, you know what, that because there's a lot of people, it's not going to really matter whether I do or I don't. No, it does. Allah's watching you. We've taken our deen too lightly. And that's a concern. Because my brothers and sisters, while some of you may think that, you know what, this guy's really pushing it down the wrong road, fine, don't believe me, but look at your prophet and his companion, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I look around and I see no one is worried anymore. No one is stressed. Everyone is in cruise control. Yeah, I don't pray. Yeah, I don't read Quran. Yeah, I don't do this. But it's okay. Where did you get that from? Oh, you obviously didn't hear. Allah said in the Quran, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Brother, yeah, maybe I'm not the best, but the Prophet of Allah said in the Sahih Hadith, مَنْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. And I think, wow, subhanallah. You understood deen better than the Prophet and his companions? No, astaghfirullah, brother, I didn't say that. Then what are you saying? Why is it that the Prophet and the companions were worried and you and I were not worried? No one is stressed anymore. Have you noticed? Yeah, I do what I can, if I get the chance, if I get around to it. Whatever Allah allows me to do. Well, they were worried and stressed, and you and I were not worried and stressed. Your Prophet who was promised, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was promised paradise. Al-Maqam al-Mahmud was for him the highest possible status. The highest possible position was for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And even he used to say, I used to repent to Allah. I used to make istighfar 100 times a day. Worried. Fear. He would stand the night praying. Worried and concerned. When Allah orders him, you know, in Surah Hud and those chapters that are like it, the Prophet of Allah, he says, this surah gave me gray hairs, stress and concern. The Prophet of Allah, what are you worried about? You're free from sin, you're going to paradise. It's okay, relax. What are you worried about? He was worried and you and I, we're not worried. No one cares. My brothers, your deen is serious. Your life is serious. It's not a joke. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled. Companions were worried. And you and I were not worried. Look at our lives. Everywhere I go, it's the same song. Every country I visit, wallahi, it's the same thing wherever I go. Brother, how's your relationship with Allah? Alhamdulillah, it's not the best. Why isn't it the best, Ya Akhil Kareem? I'm busy. What are you busy with? What are you busy with? How's your Quran? Not the best. Can you read Arabic? No, Allah, I'm not an Arab. Nothing. We fail in everything. And what's worse, you know, that's half the problem. You know what's worse than this? Is every one of us, if we're honest here tonight, every one of us is convinced beyond all doubt that I'm definitely going to Jannah. But what proof do you have? What proof do you have that you're going to paradise? And by all means, by no means am I sending anyone to hellfire. Please don't misunderstand the message. But everyone's convinced, yeah, I'm going to paradise. Why? Because, hey, I said La ilaha illallah and the Prophet of Allah. You heard the hadith. That why is it that the prophets were concerned and you and I are not concerned? Sahaba were worried and they were promised paradise. You know what's funny? Is they were promised Jannah. And they were still worried and stressed. You and I have been promised nothing. Nothing. And we're living life in cruise control. Whatever, man. If I get the chance, inshallah, I'll come. رسول الله